Kalamazoo at the public library. I think we played here maybe 5-6 years ago, if I'm not mistaken, and we had such a great time. So we wanted to come back for quite some time. So thanks for having us. Thank you.
Thank you.
friends. Joining me on bass is Matt Hewler. And on drums is Pete Dasha. Here just said that was kind of scary. Yeah. guys scared a little bit?
No.
What's gonna happen next? Yeah. Well, I should say that all the music we're playing tonight is pretty new. This trio has been together for maybe 6-7 months, and prior to that, I was in a band, Eastern Bloc, with Matt and also Michael Kasky here, who is here from Kalamazoo. And then I was doing my guitar duo, which I came to Kalamazoo a couple times, and now kind of playing with the trio, which is really fun for me because I got to showcase, you know, some of my writing and share the music with the audiences and also with these two wonderful musicians who have also, you know, their own projects in Chicago. Matt plays with his own large ensemble that just released a double disc called In the Ivory. And I believe you have one or two copies, one of them. And he has a concert coming up at the Green Mill in Chicago, which is kind of an amazing place. And Pete here, who's become a very good friend in a very, very short period of time, but I've been following him for a couple of years now. He plays with a band called Misremember, which is a wonderful sort of rock Americana group. And when I heard his record, I liked it so much, I asked Pete to play with us, and he said, I don't have anything else going on. I'm kind of bored at home, so I'll play with you, sure, that's fine. But in any case, like I said, Matt has a wonderful project called Loom. The album is called In the Ivory, and Pete's band is called Misremember, which three albums. And we are about to record all this music that we're gonna play for you throughout this evening, which I'm really excited about because it's you know, it's kind of I think for the first time in my life I'm starting to be happy with the way I'm writing music, which in the past I was you know, I kind of like something that I would write for maybe 3-4 months and then secretly I would just stop calling the tune in the shows, like, let's just bury that one. What was I thinking, you know? But I think I found a niche, well, a niche in terms of guitar music. And like you maybe know, there's a lot of what we call them shredders on the guitar. And I love to shred, I love to play fast, but I also like the song to be very song-like so that you could actually sing it. Versus just impress people for the sake of playing fast or loud. So I think the music that I've been writing recently is very, I feel like it, you know, the composition kind of gets a life of its own, and I, you know, during the process of me writing it, I feel that it's a commitment that I have to be fully responsible in terms of the amount of notes, exact amount of notes and exact kind of chord changes, because you write some, you know, start writing something and you have one or two chords and then suddenly you know, there is a rolling feeling of continuity that you have to kind of respect. That's why I feel like a composition has a life of its own that we have to pretty much respect as musicians. So speaking of compositions and respect, we're gonna play a tune that's sort of a ragtime, but not really. I call it, what do I call it? I call this one Maurice's Rag, partially Maurice Ravel, and then ragtime. And I would tell this story in a concert, like it's partially inspired by Ravel and partially a ragtime tune. And then I would ask the audience, did you notice that? And mostly everybody says, no, not at all. So let's hear Maurice's Rag. Is that about 6 minutes speech right there? It's pretty good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Doing, having fun?
Yeah.
Yeah? This is almost like we're at Bell's Brewery, right? Yeah. Man, oh man, you know, a few weeks ago I played a concert around here, and you know, we got so used to playing at bars late at night, which is fine, nothing against that. It's still people, but people get drunk, so they become like easy audience. You know, we play too, like, yeah. So a few weeks ago I was playing a dry show, And sometimes a dry audience is hard, you know, hard to get, you know? I was like, is it me, is it them? I don't know, you know? Do I need a drink? Do they need a drink? All the joking on the side, it's nice to play in a place where we don't need drinks to enjoy music. So thank you so much for being so nice.
Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And once again, give it up for Pete, who played a killer drum solo.
Thank you.
Thank you.